Thank you for watching and welcome to chapter 14, in which we are going to learn how we can create our drawings from different parts. So right now I am into the software. So what I would like to do is I would like to go into the file and then go into the new. So one thing which you already know, like whenever you are gonna open the SolidWorks part, assembly or drawing, you are always going to use some kind of template. So as you can see, whenever you are opening the software, so you can see these are the options. So if you are going to open the part assembly or drawing, so if you don't have any template, so these part assembly or drawings, they are going to be opened by using a default template. So there is an option like I can go into the advanced. This is the option. And as you can see, there are options for templates. So if you already have some templates, so you would see the menus here. And if you don't have any template, so then you are gonna open all these parts, drawing or assemblies with the default template. So right now I don't have in this PC any template. So, but what we are gonna do is we are just gonna open a drawing. We are gonna create our own templates and then we are gonna add those templates here. At the end of the video, we would see how we can add those templates into the SolidWorks. So I'm gonna go with the drawing and opening this drawing sheet by default template. Okay, so when you are opening the default template, so you can see like there are sheet formats which you need to select. Like there are common sheet formats like A0, A1, A2, A3 or A4, which kind of page size or sheet size you want to have. Suppose if you want to have A3, or if you already have some your own sheet sizes, you can browse and you can bring your own sheet sizes. Or if you want to have customized sheet sizes, you can go here and you can have customized sheet sizes. But I'm gonna go with the A3 right now and then I'm gonna click the button OK. And this is model view. I don't want to see the model view right now. What I want to do is I would like to right click on that and I would like to edit sheet format, because we are going to create our own template. So I'm gonna edit sheet format. Okay, so the thing is, why you are gonna save your own templates, or why you are gonna to have your own specific sheet? Because if you are working for different companies, or if you are working for different divisions, so whenever you need to make your drawings again and again, so this is gonna save you a lot of time. If you already have some specific template for some specific project, or for some specific company, if you are working for different companies, so in this way it's gonna save over a lot of time. So right now, as we are going to create our first template, so you can see when I am into the edit sheet, so there are different things what we can update or what we can modify. So as you can see, there are different things which start with the dollar, which is PRP sheet, description and material and finish. So these are the things which are gonna automatically import from the part. So when we are importing our part into the sheet, so these things are automatically modified with respect to the part. And in the next video, of course, we are gonna learn how we would modify or update these things into the part, and then these are gonna update automatically here in the sheet. But there are some other things, like there are some other boxes you can see, like you can edit the name if you want to mention, like when is this drawing is approved, what is manufacturing date, what is quality assurance date, or anything like that. So you can add the name, you can signature, and you can add the date as well. And there are other things which you can update if you want to update any some kind of specific information here. So you can double click on that and then you can add your information here. Or if you don't want to, if you don't like this kind of information box here, what you can do is you can just go into the sketch as you are already into the sheet, and then you can create your own boxes or your own style, whatever style you want to have. And there is an interesting thing, if you want to work, if you are working for a company or some special branch and you have a logo, so you can add their logo as well. So you can create your boxes for logo, or you can just update any existing boxes. So I'm just going to update this existing boxes into the logo. And then what I would like to do is I would like to add a logo here. So to add a logo here, we would like to go into the sketch, and here is the sketch picture. So I can import my logo here, but I just add this for myself because I was adding logo for another drawing. But if you cannot see this thing here, what you can do is you can right click any of the tab here, and then you can go into the customize. And then into the customize, you can see like you have a control and toolbar, shortcut bars, commands, menus, whatever you want to bring into your into the ribbon section. So I'm gonna go into the commands, and then into the sketch I added it from here into the commands. I am into the command and then into the sketch section, and here is the sketch picture. So I can bring it, I just drag it and I bring it to the, like that, I bring it to my ribbon section. So right now I have two like that. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you. So what I want to do now is I just want to bring a logo here. So I'm gonna sketch picture, I'm double click on it, and exercise file, this is chapter 14, and in 14.1 I have this logo. So I'm double click on it. So this logo is gonna be import here, as right now it is here, and it has a background. And into that feature manager, as you can see on transparency, so if you want to remove the background, so as I did it from the logo, because this is a PNG, so I can remove it from the my file. So what I would select is from the file, so in this way I can just remove my logo background. So then I'm gonna reduce the size, and then I'm gonna bring it here. So we are gonna add our logo maybe here. Okay, so in this way we can add our logo as well, or if we want to add some other information, if we want to add the names and dates and signature, whatever you want, so you can add. So these things, as I already mentioned, like the description, material, weight, and these things are automatically gonna import from the part. Okay, other than that, if you would like to add some kind of note, so you can go into the annotations. Before that we were in sketch, and now we are into the annotation, and then you can click this note, and you can click anywhere, and then you can add any type of notes. So instead of adding notes, if you want to add, or if you want to enter some kind of hyperlinks, like if someone is going to click on that and it's going to bring into the different website, so what you can do is you can go into the feature manager, and into the here, as you can see, there is an option for insert hyperlink. So you can insert your hyperlinks, or what you can do is you can go to the next option, which is link to the property. So you can, what you can do is you can link to some specification on to this property, so you can customize properties from current document or model found here. So I would like to go into the select component or other new drawing, and then you can select any property or any kind of information if you would like to add. So like right now there are different options if I want to add, so total sheets or title or created date. Let's add the date here. So as you can see, I can add the day and the date, and if I want to show time, I can just check this or uncheck this. If you want to have a date format long or short, so this is the short format, this is the long format, so whatever kind of format you want to have, you can just bring it to here and then click OK, and then again green check mark. Okay, and then you can move wherever you want to move it. So whenever you are done with all of your modification or update, so what you can do is you can just right click on the green check mark, and then I would like to save this drawing as my template. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go into the files, and then I would go into the save as, and right now as I am in chapter 14, so I would go into chapter 14 and into 401, and instead of SolidWorks drawing, I would like to save it as a drawing template. Oh no, not this one, this one. So drawing template, so I can save my drawing. So suppose drawing for ABC company. So I can just save it like that, and then I would save it into the my, it's gonna save into the templates. No, I want to save into the exercise file, chapter 14, 1401, and I want to save it draw ABC and drawing template, and then I'm gonna click the save button. So in this way I can save my template. Okay, then I'm just gonna exit this template. Okay, right now as we already have our own template and we already saved it, but we didn't add it and we did not provide the path to the software. So what we can do is we can go into the file and new, and as you can see into the advanced, we don't have any path for our template here. So what we need to do is we need to add our template, add our path. So what I would like to do is like I'm back into the drawing environment again, and you can see you can go into the options, and then into the options you can go into somewhere file locations, into the system options, and then you can go into the file locations here. And as you can see, these are the options which are all the path files already added. So what I would like to have is, if I would like to add one more path, so I'm gonna click on add button here, and then I want to add the folder. So as we already saved our template in chapter 14 and 14_01, so I'm just gonna select the folder. So you are not able to see any parts or any templates here because we need to select a folder right now. So I'm just gonna select this folder, and then look, this is added here, and then I'm gonna click OK. So it's gonna ask multiple times, do you really want to add the path? So you need to click yes, yes, multiple times. Okay, now if I'm gonna just delete this drawing, and then I'm gonna go back into the file and into the new, and then I'm gonna go back into the advanced, and you can see here we already added our file path here, so which is 14, and we already have two templates here. So this is the one which was already there. So this is the draw ABC which we created and then we saved, and now we already provided the path as well. So if I'm gonna open this, as you can see, we have all those options, like we already added our logo and all other information and data as well. So this was all about this video, in which we have just covered how we can use different templates and how we can made our own templates and how we can create path links into the software. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you.